good morning, or maybe it's good afternoon or good evening, whatever time you are connecting with our worship video for this week. We want to welcome you. My name is Reverend Isaac Mundy. I'm the minister here at Trenton United Church, and I'm here with our music director, Dianne Goyetche, and we're glad to be in this virtual worship space with all of you folks this morning, or afternoon, or evening. Well, we want to be able to just move through a few different announcements before we begin our time for worship. First of all, just to let you know, you'll get a couple more reminders through the worship, but we are going to be celebrating communion, and so if you want to be able to participate at home, feel free to go get some bread to be able to eat, or even a cracker, or some juice to be able to have the elements there for communion to be able to participate. So if you want to press the pause button, sometimes it's there in the middle of the screen or down over here, however you want to do that, feel free so that we can be able to share in communion together. I wanted to let you know too, this coming week, we are going to be having our session with Reverend Katie and Allison on therapeutic touch. And it's going to be taking place on the 6th, so that's the Thursday in the afternoon. All the details are there in your weekly email message that you normally get going out by email, but that information will also be there. You can click through to that to the announcements on the main page of trentonunited.ca. There is still time if you want to be able to sign up for that session. We would love for you to be able to do so. And so we hope that you'll be able to join us for our session on therapeutic touch, kind of a healing practice, very much compatible with the life of faith. And so we hope that you'll be able to join us, and we'll send you a Zoom link if you let us know at the office that you're interested in participating. Also coming up, not this coming week, but in several weeks' time, we're also going to be having a study group with Reverend David on the themes of prayer, and looking forward to that one as well. And so please, we'll ask you to also sign up for that session as well at the office, and then we'll be able to send you the Zoom link for those sessions as well. And I want to let you know too, I believe that we have an announcement in this week's announcements, and we will continue to have them, but our Faith Development Committee is setting up a different way of being able to be in touch with one another during this pandemic time and in the midst of the lockdown, a pen pal program. And we're kind of hoping that this can be an intergenerational pen pal program between some of the young people of our congregation and some of the non-school age members of our congregation. So check out that announcement again in your announcement sheet. And we'd love it if you would be able to sign up. So please let us know, and you can let us know through the office. And Marie Holdaway is also doing a lot of the coordination work for this. So we'd love to have you sign up and join in this really great way of being able to stay connected with one another, even when we can't be in this physical space all at once. I think that's all the announcements that I am going to bring to your attention this morning, but again, you can always look in the announcement sheet. And also, if you want to follow us on social media, you can do so by following us on Twitter or on Facebook. And also, just let us know at the office if you'd like to sign up for our weekly email blast, and we'd love to have you on our list and to be in touch with all of you folks. I should say as well, folks, in the midst of this time, as when it's difficult to be together too, we want to be letting Reverend Ed know that in the midst of this time of loss, after the loss of Betty and her passing away earlier this week, let's keep Reverend Ed in our prayers. Many of you will have known Reverend Ed. He was an interim minister here at Trenton United before I arrived here. He was here between 2016 and right up to the end of 2017, and still very much a part of our church family. So let's send lots of love and our prayers to the Bentley family over the next little while. Friends, let's begin our time of worship, and I offer you a sign of Christ's peace. May Christ's peace be with you all as we gather for worship. Peace of Christ, Dan.
Peace. Peace of Christ, everyone.
Well, friends, we'll begin with our candle lighting prayer as we light the Christ candle. And if you're following along at home, please join with me in the words of this prayer. In the season of Easter, God, we greet the risen Christ. We light the Christ candle, trusting in your promises for us and for all of creation. Open our hearts to worship you as we prepare our lives for the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Friends, our first musical piece and hymn will be number 202 in our More Voices hymn book, and it is Bread for the Journey. It's just one verse, so we're going to sing that verse twice, but we'll sing this as a preparation for our time of communion and worship for today. Our scripture reading for today comes from chapter 22 of the Psalms, Psalm 22, verses 27 to 31. So let's listen to these words of scripture. All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall worship before him. For dominion belongs to the Lord, and he rules over the nations. To him, indeed, shall all who sleep in the earth bow down. Before him shall bow all who go down to the dust, and I shall live for him. Posterity will serve him. Future generations will be told about the Lord and proclaim his deliverance to a people yet unborn, saying that he has done it. May God bless our understanding of Scripture as Dianne leads us in our ministry of music. Thank you. Thank you so much, Dianne. It's such a lovely piece. Well, folks, our message for today is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to invite you actually right into my kitchen, where I'm going to be getting some baking lessons, because we're going to share in some communion bread and juice in a few minutes. But I kind of wanted to take you into that process and also introduce you to the master chef who was helping me do all the baking at our household this past week. So let's take a moment now to connect to this video. Hi folks, so I'm at our kitchen at home during this whole stay-at-home order, and just wanted to be able to share with you a little bit about our Bible passage, but also about our kitchen. The reason why I'm in the kitchen is in just a few seconds, I'm going to show you a little video of me as an assistant to our master bread maker in our house, and the individual who made the bread that we're going to be using for communion. Even if you want to hit pause right now beforehand and go and get some bread and juice, because we'll be sharing in communion pretty soon, you can feel free to do so. But our scripture passage from the Psalms that was part of the lectionary for today made me think a bunch about communion. I'm going to explain to you just a little bit why, because it kind of deals with the past, the present, and the future. It starts out, part of it at least, talking about, to God indeed shall all who sleep in the earth bow down, before him shall bow down all who go down to the dust. So there's really this sense that those who have gone before us are still very much a part of who we are as a community of faith, and even our own paths have been a part of that. And that's important when we think about communion, because it's when we think about a lot of the different parts of the communion prayer, we're remembering what God has done, what Jesus has done at different points in our history, but also in terms of thinking about our own history, both as individuals and as families and communities. So it's important to be able to bring that into who we are. But then we move into the present moment, where it talks about, and I shall live for him. So this sense that really right in this moment, we are also part of God. It's not just about our past, but we're bringing our past into our present. And then finally, we see that posterity will serve God. Future generations will be told about the Lord and proclaim his deliverance to a people yet unborn, saying that he has done it. There is this sense that we are also moving towards the future as individuals, as families, as communities of faith, and that we have reason to hope that there are people that have been yet to be born, but through what has happened in the past and through what we are doing now, we can move forward into the future, trusting that God is still gonna be at work in our lives, that God won't give up on us, and that we can still have that sense of hope moving forward into the future. That's why in our communion prayer, we say, Christ has died, looking to the past. Christ is risen, so that sense of the resurrection happening right now, not just a thing in the past, that we're part of that resurrection now, and Christ will come again, that we can trust that Spirit is going to be at work and moving in our futures. And so I want to break this down a little bit in terms of the video I'm going to show you. So why don't we open that up, and then you can have a gander at what I was talking about, what I'm talking about in terms of the whole bread making thing. Let's have a look. So to start off, I'm here in the kitchen with the master chef, helping them get out all of the different ingredients that are from the cupboard. That's kind of like bringing parts of our past out into the present. And you know, some of our spices and sugar and stuff like that doesn't look all that amazing. It's probably the same for a lot of us in terms of our past too, that we've got blessings and challenges there. But then we start to mix things together in the present and bring all of those different ingredients into who we are right now. And sometimes we spell each other off a little bit and get that dough together, and then we start mixing together, and there's this back and forth between different generations a lot of the time. And sometimes we really got to work that dough and throw it up and down and all around and get it ready. And then, okay, now it's over into the bowl, and watch this bread rise, a little bit of time lapse there, that sense of God moving into our future. We know that our future isn't gonna be perfect either. We've got the challenges, and sometimes we gotta work that dough back down after it's risen and get some of our siblings in Christ in there as well to be able to, oh yeah, get that dough really worked down and then pop it into the oven and let the Holy Spirit be at work as it rises up. And we can trust that there will be that future where we will be nourished heading into whatever may come. And that's what we share when we're sharing the communion bread. So I'm looking forward to being able to share this liturgy with you wherever you are and wherever you are watching this video. And hopefully by this point you have some bread and juice, or if you just want to participate in whatever way works best for you, we're glad to be able to share in communion, share in Christ, and trust that God is a part of our past, our present, and our future. And for that we can say, thanks be to God. Amen. Folks, I hope that you enjoyed that sharing and being able to connect in that way with the process of what goes into making the communion bread and how we are brought together, both in terms of our past and our present and our future in the presence of God. Folks, let's join now in our time of communion, and we'll begin with our communion prayer. And so you can feel free at home, however you want to be able to pray this, whether you want to be listening to me or if you want to be able to read along, you please feel free to do so. Friends, let us lift our hearts to God with our prayer of thanksgiving. God, today we gaze at the creation all around us. Thank you for budding leaves, golden flowers, and blooming magnolia trees. For everything you have done to coax life from the earth, both now and for eons before humanity appeared on the earth, we cry, holy, blessed, glory, Hosanna, our voices echoing the joy of spring. We lift up gratitude for Jesus, our teacher, our healer, our redeemer. He came to those without religious expertise, but whose hearts were open. He spoke to children, foreigners, workers, and those outside the world's norms. In him, they found new life. And together with them, we receive hope for the future. On the night that he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is the blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. As a people that remembers and as a people that hopes, we affirm that for each one of us, Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, upon us, upon all people, upon all of the creation. We pray for those who have lost loved ones this week. We pray for family and friends who are struggling and living at a distance from us. We pray for those whose livelihoods have been made uncertain by COVID, for students, teachers, and families navigating at-home learning, for hospital, long-term care, and funeral home workers trying to find balance in an uncertain world, for all those in India who are suffering and lost in the deadly wave of virus that is impacting their country, and for those who lost loved ones or who were injured in the recent stampede in Israel. Empower us to be agents of change and healing for our world, as we bless and glorify you, our triune God, both now and forever. Amen. Friends, I will invite you to join me now in the Lord's Prayer. Let's pray these words together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Friends, this is the body of Christ, broken for you. The blood of Christ, shed for you. And friends, as you partake in whatever way you feel most comfortable at home, I will partake as well here of the bread and the cup. Let's join together now at Christ's table. Friends, let us pray. We have shared the bread and the juice. We have tasted the goodness of your kingdom. Holy Spirit, come to us. Anoint us with your strength, so that through your nourishing love, we might journey onward to share your goodness with the wider world. Amen. Friends, let's join now in singing our closing hymn, which is number 289, It Only Takes a Spark. It only takes a spark to get a fire going, and soon all those around can warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with God's love. Once you've experienced it, you spread God's love to everyone. You want to pass it on. What a wondrous time is spring, when all the trees are budding, the birds begin to sing, the flowers start their blooming. Oh, it is with God's love. Once you've experienced it, you want to sing. It's fresh like spring. You want to pass it on. I wish for you, my friend, this happiness that I found. On God you can depend. It matters not where you're bound. I'll shout it from the mountain top. I want my world to know the Lord of love has come to me. I want to pass it on. And friends, as we draw to the close of, or draw the service to a close, we want to thank you for all the ways that you are passing on God's love, and for all the ways that you contribute to the life and ministry of this church through your time, talent, and treasure. So let's bless one another, and let's bless the gifts that we share with one another. I'll invite you to speak these words, if you have them in front of you with me at home. God, you have woken us from our slumber and led us to a new day of hope. As an Easter people, bless the offerings we share in faith. Bless us too as we go from this place, proclaiming Christ's resurrection and sharing in the Spirit's compassion. Amen. Friends, as you go out into whatever the rest of your day looks like, know that all of your past, your present moment, and all of your future are connected and held in God's love. As you go forward and think of the ways that you can pass on that love, trust in the ways that God is leading us forward in hope. Go now in peace.